Mesdames, Messieurs, bonjour au micro de Radio Shalom, Charles Hugassi. Radio Shalom vous convie maintenant à l'écoute de l'allocution de l'ancien grand rabbin Ashkenaz d'Israël, le Rav Meir Lau, qu'il a prononcé à Montréal à l'occasion de la soirée de la Yeshiva Yavne au centre Chabad de Côte-Saint-Luc. L'ancien grand rabbin Rav Meir Lau, qui est lui-même un rescapé de la Shoah, a tenté de démontrer durant son discours et durant son allocution que le peuple juif est là pour rester, qu'il est immuable et éternel. Et comme vous l'écouterez dans l'enregistrement qui va vous être diffusé à l'instant, il a démontré que tous les peuples de l'époque et les anciens peuples qui ont existé ont eux-mêmes disparu et nous et le peuple juif est maintenant encore présent. D'ailleurs, il ne savait pas si bien dire, puisque son propre fils est maintenant grand rabbin Ashkenaz d'Israël, le Rav Lau. Alors, prêtez l'oreille, voici maintenant l'allocution du grand rabbin Rav Meir Lau.
Chief Rabbi of the Sfardi community in Montreal, Kol Baranam Rabbanan Rabbanim and Nikbadim, Dorei HaTorah, Mechabdim Otanu B'Mahamad Hazeh, all the friends, mainly the teachers, the educators, ladies and gentlemen in Yavne, Yeshiva, all the supporters, את צחקים הנה מחזיקים בה. מוריי ורבותיי, קהל קדוש. 3,320 years ago, when we came out from Egypt, Exodus, and we became a nation, Mount Sinai, היום הזה נהיית לעם, להשם אלוקיך, we were not the only nation on the stage. There were very many nations, even bigger, larger, most powerful empires in that time and later. Let's assume few of them that we know. Ammon, Moab, Plishtim, Aram, Edom, Amalek, Tsor v'Tzidon, Tziklag, Ashur, Babel, פרס ומדי, יוון, רומא, קרטגו. Tell me, where is one of these nations today? One of them. With the culture, with the religion, with the concept of life. Tell me one of these nations. and they didn't suffer an abuse. They were not expelled from Spain in 1492, not from England in 1290. They didn't suffer a genocide. Babel, Persian, Greek, classic Roma. Do you know the great-grandchild of Hannibal, the ruler of Carthago, who have defeated Roma? Give me the name of a descendant of Hannibal. There is no one of them. Disappeared. York. But the descendant of Aharon HaKohen, you gave him this morning Aliyah. The first Aliyah was given to the Kohen. Great-great-grandchild of Aharon HaKohen. We exist in spite of the Holocaust, in spite of the exiles, in spite of the destruction of the first temple and the second one. Babylon had destroyed our first one, 586 before Era. Roma have defeated and destroyed our second one, 70 past Era. Where are they, Aspasianus and Titus? Roma of Aspasianus is not Roma of Berlusconi. Not the same language, it's not Latin. Instead of Jupiter, there is a Pope in Roma today, the Vatican. Different at all. Geographically, it's the same land, the same country. But inside, it's a different nation. Greece of Socrates, Aristotle, Plato, or Alexander Mordor is not Greece of today, or Papandreou and Karamanlis. The Theodorakis, a different language. They don't speak the Latin classic. There is no Zeus there. There is a church. A church. A branch of Vatican. Different at all. Amon Moab. Amon had a goddess named Milcom. Moab had a goddess named Chemosh. Where are they? King Abdullah, the son of King Hussein, grandson of another King Abdullah. Arab, Islam, it's not Milcom, it's not Kmosh, it's not the same language. Sichon Melech Haemori, Og Melech HaBashan, they were in Transjordan, in the eastern bank of the Jordan. Where are they? Disappeared. And the Jewish people, small world, full of misery and sufferings, the only one who exists since then, the only one. Egypt of Papo is not Egypt of Sisi, or Mubarak, or all the others, or Sadat, no. Not the same language, not the same religion. They had a goddess, Noamon. Today, Islam, Shiites, Sunnis, Islam, different mentality, everything different. Egypt of Pharaoh doesn't exist. But Am Israel of Moshe Rabbeinu do exist till now, here in Montreal, wherever, the whole world. If Moshe Rabbeinu will come and we will meet him, and he will say us, Shalom Aleichem. We answer with the same language, Aleichem Shalom. And we will understand each other. And we put that feeling that he ordered us to put that feeling there. Not even one word is missing. Shema Israel, Vayayim Shamoah, Kadesh, Vehaya Kevyacha. We put all the talit that he gave us, Vasu Lahem Tzitzit. What is the answer? How can you explain that all the nations collapsed, ran bankrupt, and do not exist anymore? The only one of that classic time, 3,300 and more years ago, do exist, the Jewish people. Why? The answer is Yavneh. Yavneh, Telli Yavneh Vachachamea, was asking Rabban Yochanan ben Zakkai, as it was mentioned by Rabbi Chadad Shita, this is the answer. Instead of Beit HaMikdash, we have got a Beit HaMidrash. Yavneh replaced Yerushalayim spiritually. Yavneh taught us a lesson. One of the students of Rabban Yochanan ben Zakkai was Rabbi Eliezer HaGadol ben Horkanos, a phenomenal memory. One of the students of Rabbi Eliezer HaGadol was Rabbi Akiva. One of the students of Rabbi Akiva was Rabbi Meir or Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai. Rabbi Meir of Pesach Sheni yesterday, Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai of Thursday this week. Students of Rabbi Akiva. The student of Rabbi Meir was Rabbi Yehuda HaNasih. He formulated Shisha Sidrei Mishnah. And all the halacha, the Gemara, the Rif, the Rambam, and the Chaver, Rabbi Yosef Karo, everything based on the Mishnah formulated by Rabbi Yehuda HaNasih. This is the answer. How can you explain that all the other nations disappeared and we exist? They were not liquidated in gas chambers, no. They have assimilated. Ammon has its Milcom and Moab has its Kmosh, their goddess. When Ashur became an empire, Sancherib, Shalmaneser, Tiglath-Pileser, all, they brought a new goddess named Evil Merodach. So Ammon and Moab assimilated into Ashur, in the Syrian Empire. When Babylon took over Ashur, Nebuchadnezzar and the others, they came with another goddess named Bel. All the people in the Middle East changed their religion and they started to serve Baal. Then came Persia, Dariush, Koresh, Xerxes, Ahasuerus. They had another goddess, two, Hormis and Hurmi. Hormis brought the light, Hurmi brought the darkness, and they are fighting each other. That's why Yeshayahu, Isaiah, the prophet said, Ani Hashem yotzer or uvore choshech. Ose shalom uvore ra. Ani Hashem ose kol el. That we say every morning before Kriyat Shema, yotzer or uvore choshech, ose shalom uvore et hakol. This was the answer to the Persian religion. That is divided, light and darkness, Hurmis, Hurmis. All the Middle East changed into this religion of Paras and Madai. 127 Medinot, as we read in the book of Esther. And then came Yavan, Greek, new empire, with polytheism, many, many goddesses, Neptune and Bacchus and Mars and Aphrodite and Helene. God forbid. And they changed. They came to Rome with the same thing until Christianity came and the Islam appeared and all these nations assimilated from one religion to the other. Except we. Matityahu Kohen Gadol, he said in Modi'in, when the Greece came in, he said, not here. Hellenistic culture, not here. Mila Hashem Elad. And the five sons, Yudai, Shimon, and Yonatan, and Yohanan, and Elazar, they became one feast.
And they fought shoulder to shoulder with the father, old Matityahu. And they said, not here. We are Jews. We are Jewish life, and we will not desecrate the Shabbat, and we will not eat this food. We keep kosher. We have a Shabbat. We believe in the Lord Almighty. He is the master of the universe. So what kept us alive? The education, the tradition, the Jewish heritage. I spoke now about history. Let's speak for a while in history. Let's speak about the present. I know a little bit the Jewish law, all over the laws. I can tell you that the great, great threat for the Jewish people is, of course, assimilation and intermarriages. I made an investigation. Where are the cities in the world that is the minimum of intermarriages, minimum of assimilation? Where is it? Unfortunately, not New York. New York, the grand rabbis, yeshivot and everything, 52% of intermarriages in the Greek of New York, state of New York, 52%. One of two Jewish children is getting lost. Baltimore, Panama City, San Paulo, Monterrey in Mexico, Johannesburg, Cape Town, Sydney, Melbourne, Antwerp in Belgium, Manchester in the United Kingdom. In these cities is the minimum of intermarriages. Monterrey, Mexico, because of one Rabbi Kaiman, because of one Jewish school, King David School, and all the Jewish children, 260 people, learn only in the Jewish school, not in the public one. This is their young man, King David is the name. There is no one case of intermarriages in the city of Monterrey in Mexico. So there is a close and clear connection between no assimilation and no intermarriages between them to Jewish education. Where you have a strong school, where you have a yeshiva studies, where you have a Beit Yaakov for the girls, of a kind of Beit Yaakov. These places are a promise for the Jewish future, for the Jewish eternity. That's why we are gathered here tonight in college, Rabbi Al-Hadad, his friends, the Rabbanim, the leaders of the community, the leaders of Yalta Yeshiva School, with the academic studies, but in the way, in the concept of Torah, Mitzvot, and Emunah. This is not only a good education. This is the future. This is our eternity. Without the Hoda'atam Levanecha Ve'Livnei Vanecha, you have to tell your children and children's children, Yom Asher Amadeta Lifnei Hashem Elokecha Mekolel. Tell them about the day you stood at Mount Sinai, receiving the Torah, saying, Na'aseh V'Nishma, and we gave a promise, we will keep, we will observe the 613 commandments. Later on, we will listen and know and learn exactly what you, Master of Universe, what you ask from us. I have seen Moshe Dayan here and his friends. They are working on a program about Abraham Avinu. A video, a cassette, whatever. to tell the children about Abraham Avinu. Very nice. Abraham Avinu has a promise from the Ribono Shel Olam, which nobody has the same. When Ribono Shel Olam wants to tell him about what he's going to destroy, Sodom v'Amorah, Sod Hashem Yireav, the secrets the Almighty divides with the people who were here. He had decided to tell Abraham Avinu, HaMechaseh Ani Me'Abraham Asher Ani Oseh, I am going to do to destroy the secret stone. I will not cover as a secret it from him. I have to tell him. Why? Ki Yeda'atif, says Rashi, what is Yeda'atif? I love him. I love this person, Abraham. Yeda'atif is not only I know him. In the Bible, Yeda'atif, I love him. Adam yada et Chava Isho. Adam et Chava, great love, first couple. Yada et Chava Isho. He loved her. Ki yeda'atif, says Ribono Shel Olam, I love Avraham Avinu. Why? Why do I love him? He's a human being, fresh in blood, and I'm the Lord Almighty. Why do I love him? You would say, because Urkasi, he was ready to sacrifice his life into the flames of the world? No, this is not the reason. Maybe because of Lechata, to go on Aliyah in age of 75, and no one is expecting him there. No Jewish government, no Jewish agency, nothing at all. Hello? Lechata. Even not because of that. Because of Pidyon Shvuim, we have liberated all the Shvuim, Lot, from Kedar La'omer. No. Because of the starvation which was here and it didn't complain. No. Because Brit Milah, he made a circumcision in age of 99. This is the reason why I love him? No. Hachnasat Orchim. Not even this. Akedat Yitzchak, binding of Isaac. Not even this. So why Yeda'atif? Why do I love Abraham Avinu? The Torah says, Leman, because Asher Yetzaveh, he will order et banav, his children, then Beito Achrav, his family, v'shamru derech Hashem, they will observe the way of life of Hashem. La'asot tzedakah u'mishpat. To do faith, tzedakah, charity, and justice. Derech Hashem. It means very simple. I love Abraham Avinu, not because of his 10 tests, but because of one thing. He is a father. He is a teacher. He does educate his family to walk in Derech Hashem, in the way of the God. Because he's a good educator. I love him. So we as fathers, we as grandfathers, we as educators, as rabbanim, this is the main task of our life. The most holy duty in life. To promise the generations to come. To promise the future, the survival of the very existence of the Jewish people as one family. I was told that Montreal is outstanding. Kol Yisrael Haverim. Ashkenazim, Sfaradim, more religious, less religious yet, but they are all together united in one beautiful community. This is outstanding. It's very rare, seldom. We do appreciate and we salute you. I come from Eretz Israel. Yesterday I left the land. Tomorrow morning, please God, I'm going back home. I salute the Montreal Sfaradi community for its unique, united unity. The unity of the community. One main task we have, to preserve our existence to the future, to the generations to come. This is the way. Holocaust is the holy memory, Zachor v'lo tishkach. But the holiest memory will be if we make the holies unforgotten. And this we can get and accomplish only in the way of Jewish heritage, in the way of Jewish education. I thank you for being here. I thank you for listening to these words. And I thank you even more for assisting Rabbi Yochanan, his members, and the spirit of Chief Rabbi Sabach, who teaches us what is the real way to promise that we, Am Israel, Chai, Lekayam, La'at, Ulenesach, Netzachim. Amen. Thank you.